Hello you gorgeous lovely people, this is Chris from Recombu and I'm here with Motorola's shiny new Moto G6 Plus. So this is the most premium, action-packed member of the new G6 family. It's slightly larger than the other two models and it's also got slightly better performance as well, according to the specs at the very least. We will see if that is indeed the case. We're just going to do an unboxing now, get it all set up and run through the specs, the hardware, the software, so you know everything that you need to know about this lovely shiny handset. So first of all, the box itself is, of course, as you can see, that lovely lime green colour that we enjoyed from the other two members of the Moto G family. We have, of course, done a full unboxing of the G6 and the G6 Play as well, so go check those out if you want to see more about the other handsets. But now we'll concentrate on the Plus model. There we go, there's the actual phone itself. We're going to stick that aside just for a second and just check out what's in the rest of the box. Well, this looks very familiar if you've already seen our other unboxings. Little cardy bit there, lots of stuff to read. Read me! It just basically shows you how to get the phone all set up and lots of different languages. You also get, of course, a USB cable, shocker, Type-C, to actually power it back up. And a bit of a 3-pin power plug as well. Oh, and of course, not forgetting the little pin porky device so you can actually get your SIM card in there and use it as a phone. And that's basically your whack. Easy job. Brush all that away and now we can take a look at the sexy stuff, the actual handset itself. Now first of all, worth pointing out of course, that like the other two models in the G6 family, this comes wrapped in a protective sheath so you can bang it about the place and hopefully it should stay nice and fresh. That lovely glass finish, which of course is brand new for the Moto G6 series. The previous one, the G5, was a metal monster. It was still quite attractive, but of course glass is all the rage these days. So there you go, there it is in all of its sexy glory. The Moto G6 offers pretty strong value for money here in the UK, just 219 quid. But if you want something a little extra, you can add 50 bob to that price tag and get the Plus model instead. The G6 Plus offers updated specs and also a more advanced camera tech, but is it really worth that extra money? Here's our full review. Stick the Plus side by side with the standard G6 and chances are you'll have no bloody clue which is which. In fact, if the G6 Plus wasn't ever so slightly bigger, there would basically be no difference. You once again have an all-glass frame constructed from Corning Gorilla Glass 3, and this is suitably shiny and also pleasingly durable, showing no signs of scuffs or scratches despite my general cack-handed fumbling. This handset may have had some unexpected and rather sphincter-clenching interactions with some hard flooring and has come off none worse the wear. Don't worry if you're the kind of person who drops your mobile 20 times before breakfast, because Motorola has kindly bundled a cover with every handset as well. That sleek design is lovely to look at, as long as you keep those shiny surfaces buffed up. The back end is a certified fingerprint magnet, although the Indigo model does a pretty bang up job of hiding the worst of those smudges. Although the G6's 5.7 inch display has been boosted to a 5.9 incher for the Plus model, it makes bugger all difference to the overall experience. Once again, it's a perfectly sharp screen, thanks to that full HD Plus resolution. Squint as much as you like, you won't notice any pixelation when you're checking out your photos. And that 18:9 aspect ratio means no letterboxing when you're kicking back with some Netflix either. In all cases, you'll enjoy pretty punchy visuals too, thanks to that vibrancy boost feature. Of course, you can always knock that off if you prefer more realistic colour reproduction instead. If you want to rock out to some tunes, forget that tinny built-in speaker, just connect some phones either wirelessly with Bluetooth 5.0 or using a 3.5mm headphone jack. And if you prefer to carry around a massive collection of downloaded movies rather than streaming on the go, that 64GB of storage space should suffice. Admittedly, a chunk of it is already in use thanks to the OS and various other bits, but you can always expand by up to a further 128GB with microSD if you need to. As with the rest of the Moto G6 family, this is naked, raw Android as Google intended it, with a couple of little bonus features thrown in there just for good measure. For one, there's the Moto app, which adds a host of bonus features, and these actually vary in usefulness, but we definitely approve of the screen shrink feature, which helps with one-handed use, just as well as it's almost 6 inches. Other gestures also provide handy shortcuts, such as the double twist to launch the camera, not recommended for RSI sufferers, and our personal favourite, the karate chop to turn on the flash. Satisfying. Moto Key is also great, replacing Google Autofill with a scan of your fingerprint to confirm your identity when you're signing into your accounts. It's a more secure method than Google Autofill while still eliminating the need to remember a whole bunch of passwords and enter them in every time. Unfortunately, less successful is the likes of Moto Voice. This isn't anywhere near as good as the likes of Alexa at understanding natural language or actually doing what the flip you want it to, although admittedly it can be used in a pinch when driving to send a quick message and so on. Motorola has actually added face recognition to the standard G6 and G6 Plus as well. This can be used as an alternative to that brilliant fingerprint sensor found beneath the screen when your hands are otherwise engaged. It's not too successful in strong or low light, but it works perfectly well in normal conditions. For more on that Moto app, the face unlock and all the other features that we really, really love, go check out our Moto G6 Tips and Tricks guide. The Moto G6 Plus boasts the best performance of these three new Moto G6 handsets. While the other devices rock Snapdragon 400 series chipsets, the Plus model supersizes to a 600 series, namely the Snapdragon 630. That's also backed by 4GB of RAM rather than the 3GB found on the other phones to help prevent any slowdown caused by memory hog and background tasks. Of course, just because this is the beefiest G6 family member, that doesn't mean you should expect silky smooth performance at all times. We did occasionally spot an elongated pause when opening an app, for instance. That said, the Moto G6 Plus proves perfectly satisfying for everyday use. You can happily indulge in some split-screen multitasking while the latest games don't cause the phone to struggle. PUBG, for instance, plays at a pleasing frame rate on low detail levels, so you can happily frag random strangers on the internet. When it comes to battery life, the G6 Play is still the champion in the family thanks to its enormous 4000mAh cell. By comparison, the G6 Plus rocks a 3200mAh battery, which still offers some pretty good returns. Even if you're pulling this thing out of your pocket every few minutes to check emails or snap a shot, you'll happily make it to bedtime before needing a charge. And with turbo power support, the Plus refills in just over an hour. When it comes to the camera tech, the Plus is once more the big boy of the G6 family. At first glance, that hardware appears identical to the standard Moto G6. Slapped on the back is a dual lens shooter with a primary 12 megapixel lens, plus a 5 megapixel secondary lens for those portrait shots. However, while the standard G6 lenses rock an f1.8 aperture and phase detection autofocus, the beefy G6 Plus camera serves up a wider f1.7 aperture and dual pixel autofocus tech instead. The Moto G6 Plus is a more premium version of the standard Moto G6, packing a faster processor and an even bigger display, because apparently 5.7 inches just isn't satisfying enough. And when it comes to the camera tech, the Plus is once again the big boy of the bunch. At first glance, there's not much difference here. Housed on both phones is a dual lens snapper with a primary 12 megapixel lens plus a 5 megapixel secondary lens for those portrait shots. However, while the standard G6 lenses rock an f1.8 aperture and phase detection autofocus, the beefy G6 Plus camera serves up a wider f1.7 aperture and dual pixel autofocus tech. So what does any of that guffins actually mean? Well, first of all, the wider aperture means the G6 Plus should be a wee bit better in low light situations than the standard G6, and meanwhile that dual pixel autofocus technology means it should lock onto your subject a little bit faster as well, as it uses all of the pixels to focus rather than just a small percentage. Anyway, you can launch up the Moto G6 Plus camera app in the boring usual way by tapping the app icon, or in the fun, exciting and potentially hazardous way by double twisting like a morpho. Nice. The app is nicely laid out with reasonably fast access to the video mode and various bonus features, more on these shortly. You also have a number of nifty shortcuts right there on the main screen. The active photos option, for instance, shoots a brief snippet of video with each photo to bring your photo gallery to life. Great news if you shoot a lot of cat pics. Be warned, of course, that this feature does eat up more storage space. You'll also find full manual controls if you want them, although thankfully the Moto G6 Plus's auto mode is on the whole very solid indeed. Viewed on a smaller screen such as a laptop or a tablet, our G6 Plus photos look just as sharp as any taken on a more premium mobile. It's only when you check them out on a TV screen or zoom in a bit that you realise that 12 megapixel lens hasn't captured quite as much detail. Still, for everyday snaps, the results were perfectly fine. Colours are nice and punchy without appearing artificial, which especially helps out when shooting a vibrant scene. And the G6 Plus also deals well with high dynamic range, so you can merrily shoot attractive buildings or your bestie against a bright blue sky. But it's those low light situations where the G6 Plus really shows its superiority over the standard G6. For a start, that focus doesn't struggle half as much in dim conditions to lock onto your subject and produce a sharp shot. And the resultant image is much more clear, with less grain and more natural colours to enjoy. Dive into that portrait mode and you can expect pretty good results, comparable to other budget handsets like the Honor 7C. The background is successfully blurred while your subject remains pleasingly crisp, at least for the most part. There's often a wee bit of smudging around some of the edges, although nothing extreme. We also like the spot colour feature, which can isolate one particular hue and turn everything else black and white. It does occasionally glitch out a bit, but it works impressively well most of the time. If you fancy yourself as a bit of an Instagram superstar, that 8 megapixel front facing camera is a good one. You even get an LED flash to light up your face when needed. And as for video, the G6 Plus can shoot up to 4K resolution movies, a definite jump over the standard G6, which can only manage full HD at up to 60 frames per second. The lens adapts immediately to any changes in focal distance to keep your subject sharp, a benefit of that dual pixel autofocus. Harsh lighting conditions can occasionally flummox the Plus, however, with lots of lens flare and oversaturation when the sun is really beaten down. We also noticed that any kind of breeze often resulted in a bit of audio distortion, which sounded quite bad in some of our samples. Not great if you're going to film outside a lot. Go check out our video samples to see this in action. Still, the digital image stabilization at full HD resolution is rather good, helped by some serious cropping around the borders of the picture. The effects aren't quite as strong at 4K levels as you might expect, although the results admittedly aren't too jarring either. The Moto G6 Plus offers an incremental upgrade over the standard G6, although nothing too revolutionary. Yeah, this phone is a bit beefier, although everyday use isn't really noticeably nippier right now. Perhaps that extra grunt will serve you better in the long run, but only time will really tell. The only other difference of note, besides the slightly bumped up storage, is the upgraded camera tech, which does result in slightly better low light performance. Besides that, this is basically the same enjoyable Moto G6 experience, albeit for 50 quid more. We really like Motorola's sleek design work, the media chops get a big thumbs up from us, and that raw version of Android is also very good indeed. And that right there is what we think of the Moto G6 Plus. Go check out our standard Moto G6 review if you want to see what we think of the 50 quid less model. And don't forget to give us a subscribe and ding that notifications bell if you want to see reviews, unboxings, and everything else you need to know about the latest mobile tech. Thanks for watching, everyone. Love you!